HNTB works on infrastructure and light rail, subways. So we create the art that they use to take to the interview and help win projects.
In the last 5 years, we've been strictly V-Ray 3ds Max.
Sometimes it would take 5 days to get an animation rendered out.
We just don't have that kind of time anymore because we're expected to do more and more projects. The reason why our team chose Unreal, because we saw that it was an artist-first real-time application.
It was a lot easier to work with. The lighting that you get in Unreal is much more realistic than any other real-time software we've come across.
Visual scripting method inside of Blueprint allows our artists to be artists first, and then the slight tech artists secondary. On a majority of our projects, we would love to have 3 full months to create a full-blown VR experience. But unfortunately, we sometimes get called in at the last minute, and so that 3 months turns into 3 weeks. We'll go through iteration after iteration, pretty much all the way up to the day of the interview, because the project manager is still trying to figure out exactly the message that they want to tell the client.
Unreal Studio allows you to make quick iterations, so if we do need to re-import something, we don't lose all of the settings that we had set up in Unreal with colliders and LODs.
What I really like is the fact that we can see everything in real time. So if I drop a building in, I switch out the materials, I can quickly see how it's going to look compared to, you know, just the traditional rendering where you have to sit and wait to see that it was wrong.
With Unreal, you get blueprints that you can use. So we have full interaction with objects in our environment. So when you walk up to an escalator, that escalator is moving and it actually takes you up. You don't have to have a coder come in to make this thing happen. You can go and watch a couple tutorials on YouTube and it shows you exactly what you need to do. Once people actually experience VR, they see the potential in it and they see the power of it.
They put on the VR headset for the first time and they take a step back. It's like, wow, I am in this environment. And that's when you know we did it right.